My name is Jennifer Day, and I am the Chief Excrement Officer of 1-888 Canine Scoop. And I'm in the poo business because I'm passionate about dog poo.
You wake up on Friday with a hangover and you drive around picking up dog crap. I mean, that is truly a nightmare.
Yeah, but you know what? I have been picking up poo on and off professionally. I worked for another company doing it for 10 years. And like I said, I do pick up poo because I'm passionate about dog poo.
Wow.
That's a crappy business.
So, what I've learned here is there really are businesses that are on a stick.
The first one is, sorry, I'm a little nervous here.
Don't worry, it gets worse. The first 90 seconds, the chance to make the first impression, that one moment where they can crystallize the opportunity, gets blown 90% of the time.
This is instant RSVPing. This is everyone seeing. I mean, look at the...
And there's nobody doing this in the marketplace? Is not a good answer.
Right off the top, a pitcher's got to do three things. They have to captivate us, they have to have passion and show us the opportunity, and they have to talk about what they've done to date. So if they can't do those three things very, very quickly, they've lost us.
And then it got worse. How big is the market of people that would pay you $1,200?
Currently, in terms of the market for dance instructions, Statistics Canada, they estimate that 5% of the total population, just in Canada alone, is currently taking dance. Instruction of some form. That amounts to approximately
1 million troops.
And 1 million
instructors?
No, people who take dance.
Students.
Yeah.
First up, a master mechanic who wants to franchise her all-female auto repair shops. And with 99 Mr. Lube locations, she's aiming her pitch directly at Jim.
Hello, Dragons. My name's Jessica Gilbank. I'm from Toronto, Ontario. My company, you're going to love this, Jim, is called Ms. Lube by McCanchick.
Oh! Now you fucked up! Now you fucked up!
These are my McCanchicks, and we're an all-female garage.
You have fucked up!
Should we
now
gonna sue these people right away?
Right away.
Now you fucked up!
Jim, sue them.
Well, I'm sure your lawyers are way better than mine, but I do have some.
Good.
Good answer.
Now you fucked up! Now you fucked up! Now you fucked up! Now you fucked up! Now you have fucked up!
Hi, Dragons. There's something that's very intriguing. You. You're very intriguing. Aurora Castle Theme Park.
How much are you giving up for that?
Excuse me. I'll get to that.
Okay, I'll wait for that.
Brett, so rude.
Yeah, really.
Wait till you see what I have to show you.
I'm excited.
Aurora Castle Theme Park.
Is such a thing even possible?
It's a spaceship.
Exactly. But it's even more than a spaceship. Hold on, all your questions. Just for a moment. Just give me one moment. Anyone that comes in contact with this building always says when, where, how.
Nobody says why.
They never.
Never.
You're the first one.
Jeffrey, may I ask how much the building is going to cost?
$1.4 billion.
Oh, my God!
Yeah. So I'm out.
And I'm out.
I'm out.
I'm out.
King Zoltan from the planet Nebulous.
Said?
He said to be out.
Did he
I'm
say
sorry.
Be out?
I'm out.
We need this building so bad that I'm not sure what's going to happen in this planet in the next, I would give it, 3 to 6 months.
You're the first guy to come out here with a piece of paper on a tripod and have a realistic shot at getting $2 million and have a credible presentation.
Exclusively for high rollers.
Good afternoon, Dragons.
My name is Wellesley Thompson. I'm from Toronto, Ontario, and I'm here for Autobahn North Country Club. I'm here looking for $200 million for 75% of my company.
Done. I'm in.
I know. I knew, Kevin, you'd be right off the bat with that valuation, so I was hoping for a...
You have such huge kahunas that it must
That's
be a fantastic
the largest
idea.
Deal ever been asked for in the day.
Well, let's prepare to show you what I'm here to offer you. So if you could do me one huge favor and just close your eyes for a second and relax. Imagine driving 1.5 hours north of Toronto to the Autobahn Car Country Club. Now open your eyes. The Autobahn North Car Country Club is a place where people of privilege and success are able to go and either rent, purchase, or use their own exotic cars in a country club setting. You can just drive in. I'm all about the visuals here.
Wellesley, are you seriously trying to get that kind of money from us and you're coming in with a flip chart and some magic markers?
I am.
What I can't even... It's wasting my time. I'm not even going to have the conversation.
Well, I think at this state in the game, and as I can explain in further detail, it's more than just me coming in. If it was my previous business that I'm running right now, I could come in and show you my sales. I could
but
show
you, you could do. You could have done anything other than that.
So this doesn't exist. This is all in your head.
Correct. This is all an idea.
So
now,
why is it worth over $200 million today?
$266.67 million,
yes.
Why?
Why? Because I need that money to get it started. And I'm not, you know, crazy. You may think I'm coming out here in a little bit off beaten track asking for $200 million. Well, my brother and I run our own, it's a high-end service business. I won't get into details now because I'm not here to cross-promote, but we do cater to the same market and the same demographic that this business is going afterwards.
No, well, what is it, though?
It's a luxury-based service business. I don't want to get into the details because it's not what I'm here for today. My idea was to come to Dragon's Den. I didn't know what I expected when I came here. I had this idea. I've had it for a couple years. I've trying to wrap my brain around on how I could do it. And the best tangible way that I can try and find $200 million is to...
This is stupid. This is a dumb, stupid presentation.
I don't have $200 million, so I'm out. But if somebody gave you $200 million for 75%, it's just an idea. You know, 1 second later, they have $150 million.
Mm-hmm. I'm someone who's driven by passion. Passion for cars.
The only passion you got, Wellesley, is our passion, which is the $200 million.
My intention was to put this out there, quite honestly, because you never know what you get out there. When you put something out there in life, you never know how it comes back.
You're a bozo.
Bad boys, bad boys. You're a fucking cocksucker, mate. Fuck off! You are full of shit, cunt!
Now, I would like to do a demonstration. You probably haven't done any. Well, let me start again.
Okay.
You probably.
Wondering how it works.
Yeah.
Sorry. This could be a long show.
All right, here we go. Manolo, one more time with feeling, baby.
It's probably been a long time.
No.
Since you dragons.
No.
Ever. Dude, your yard work.
No! Not true.
Ave dragons, morituri te salutant.
I'm Danny.
And I'm Doug.
Euphoric.
And we are
our
Hexametric Product development.
We are developing a new exercise machine, which is called Hexametric Hexiflexi.
I was skeptical. You guys know. The way the cheap end of the exercise market works, people buy something, they use it for a week, and then it's landfill.
It's an outrage.
Exactly. I didn't want any part of that, but then Danny sprung an idea on me.
A two-dimensional exercise machine.
We all know what Buckminster Fuller did with equilateral triangles.
We do? One guy knows that. Anyway, continue.
I have a very bad habit. I make the assumption that everybody knows as much about engineering culture as I do. We discovered that, yes, equilateral triangles of elastic material and hexagons gave us real possibilities. So, development started. This doesn't look like much, does it? Nor does this. Nor does this.
Dildo.
Now we add the geometry.
We ain't doing geometry. We trying to get money.
Elastic. Something that has two-dimensional symmetry across the major axis. I'm an engineer, not a gym guy.
You look like you've been caught in a fishnet.
That I do. Yeah. Of course, I'm an engineer, and engineers really don't care what they look like.
When I look at the $250,000 for 25%, I have a problem with that.
Would you be brought in if we offered you 49.9%?
Gee, let me think about that.
No! Personally, I think we've run into the problem which I fully expected, and that's that engineers can't pitch.
It has nothing to do with the pitching. Bunch of junk.
I don't think it's a very stupid idea.
The stupid idea.
Before you leave, what was the opening chant about?
That's a geek joke. Translated, hail dragons, we who are about to die, salute thee.
Yeah, I like it. And you got slaughtered.
Foreshadowing.
Ave dragons, morituri te salutant.
All right.
Namaste.
This is something that is wrong with our entire society. We assume that any idea, no matter how complex, can be boiled down into a two-minute elevator pitch.
Hello, dragons. My name is Mislipina. I'm from... My vision of flying is different from what exists on the market right now. So this is... What it is it's a suit that we place upon ourselves. And once we're in the plane, we step outside, we look down, and we see the ground that's really far, we jump. Everything is gonna be done instantly. So once you open the legs, everything comes out.
You hope.
So this is, in English, it's called a swallow. This is gonna give you the idea of what my product is going to be. This is flight as we've never seen it before.
True, that's very true.
I think it may be just one flight you get.
I won't be putting this model in the air, all right?
Alain, I'm really concerned.
For what, Jim? This is only a model, all right? So this to give you that. The visual aspect. The object of this is not to fly through the clouds, it's to fly with the clouds.
What'll I do if something happens with the wings?
You die.
Hello, dragons. My name is Jean-Jacques Giguet.
What do people call you?
Jacques. Now, the present way we play ice hockey is basically going from here to here. And once we get here, we stop, we turn around, and then we go back and forth. There's a lot of energy being used going back and forth.
Is that trademarked? It's trademarked.
Yes, nobody verified. So it passed.
Incredible.
So what we have here is a combination of speed skating and hockey. Why? You can go here as fast as you can. You let go here. You go around the net. It's like this. You don't lose much. You lose energy, but the stop and go is being eliminated because of the ellipse.
The game's the same other than the shape of the ring?
The game is a bit different, and that's for the players to decide what the game's going to be because they're the one going to be
there. Haven't decided yet.
I'm not allowed to decide what goes on here. The player is the one who knows. I cannot be in there.
Yeah, okay.
You come in here, you shoot, it comes right back. No icing. Icing no longer exists. Why? It comes back. You're not going to call icing, but the punch comes right back to you.
I thought you weren't changing the rules.
Are there rules? You're in front of me, I shoot backward, you can't touch me. We're going to eliminate obstruction. It's illogical to hit one another. We're here to skate, flow, and get this and, wow, man, go, pass, score.
I really want to see the video.
Can we have the video, please?
I only think of holding your dick. I want to have it deep inside.
You know how hard it is for the brain to go and say, I got to get by him all the time? Am I get hit here? Forget the NHL. That's great. Thank you. We're going forward.
Jacques, when you're not doing this, what else do you do?
You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I became a member of the universe.